You remember those pictures of Willie Nelson before he truly became Willie Nelson? A lot of them, I think, are like from the late 50s, early 60s. And he's in a suit and his hair is short and he kind of looks like every other guy who's trying to make music in that era. I read somewhere that he kind of woke up one day and was like, yeah, this isn't working for me. I'm just going to do what I do. And come what may, that's what I'm going to do. And of course, we know what happened. We have decades and decades of really relevant Willie Nelson music. And he's an original. He's always made original choices, and that's why I find his guitar choice really compelling. You know, he's played this classical or nylon string guitar his whole career since then. And of course, he has a favorite one he acquired, I think in 1969, it's called Trigger. It's the one that has the hole in it before having holes in your guitar were cool. But this guitar always fascinates me because it always cuts. I've seen him live with a band, and it cuts. I've seen him alone, and it cuts. There's something about the way the guitar sounds that makes it super original, and really, to me, quite valuable, actually, because it's a one of a kind. And so he and Martin grouped up there in 1999 to recreate his guitar, right down to the pickup. Even though Baldwin is out of business now, the Fishman pickup they put in these guitars, and there are only 100 of them, and only 30 with Brazilian rosewood back and sides, and that's the one of them that I'm playing. But they went down to every last detail. He was basically in the mix to figure out, how do we make this pickup sound exactly like the one I've loved for years that makes my guitar what it is? How do we make this guitar speak in the bandwidth that I find pleasing and that actually works well for me in all situations? So together they partnered and made this awesome, very limited edition Willie Nelson guitar. I'm playing it right now, and it's got his signature on it, you know, in it and also on it, and abalone on the fretboard. It's got the words Trigger up here at the 12th, then they're in abalone, and you can hear me speaking into it. It's really resonant. And then on the 5th fret, for you Lone Star people, there's a beautiful picture of an abalone of Texas, little inlay with a star. Very subtle. This guitar is really, literally, and I can say this because I've gotten to play some really amazing nylon string guitars. It's a one of a kind. It's exactly to his specs. It's all really high-end materials. As you know, the Brazilian rosewood back and sides, there's just nothing. I'm looking at it right now. There's nothing better than that. Really, it's so great now that if you try to buy a Brazilian rosewood back and sides guitar, you're going to pay a major premium if you can even find it. The soundboard is bookmatched from a solid Sitka spruce, and it has that same, like, old tint that you love, you know, that you love to see, that makes you think of him and think of really warm, round, yet able to speak tones. The fingerboard is crafted like it seems like solid, genuine ebony. And I can tell you this, that overall, it has a great feel to it. It's quite balanced, and it's got this really resonant, I mean, it just speaks. Listen to that. Just enough. Everything is just enough and pristine and beautiful, you know? And it can do all that stuff you need it to do if you're playing just finger style or jazz. And it, again, the thing I find so amazing about it is how it not only stands on its own, but cuts through a lot of other instruments. It's a very rare guitar. Literally, there are only 30 of these ever manufactured, and we don't know how many still exist or where they are, but I can tell you, this is a mint rendition of that. This is a mint, exceptionally mint guitar. If you're the type of person who likes that kind of guitar, who's interested even in preserving a part of history, who would love to be able to play your classical in front of the band without being lost, This is a guitar for you.